Welcome friends to my channel Trading Sensation. I hope you all are doing great. So by now, if you have not yet subscribed, please do subscribe my channel and share it with your near and dear ones. Yes, and if anyone wants to get in touch with me, please drop a mail. My mail ID is tradingsensation123@gmail.com. I'll also write it down in the description box. Clear? So today in this video, I'm going to explain about Nifty and Bank Nifty. So I guess it's the most popular one. I'll just try to describe or try to explain that how it is outperforming not only the emerging markets, but also the developed economies. So let me just, superimpose Dow Jones, that is US 30. So I'm putting US 30 in a new pane. So you can see that how it has outperformed US 30. So just see the movement. So over here, when US 30 made a top, I mean, it was around January 2022, but Nifty made a top before that. It's around October 2021, correct? Post 18th October 2021, the blue one is the Nifty and the below one is Dow Jones. So post October 2021, Nifty again made an all-time high around this December 2022. And then you see how this Dow Jones performed in this same time frame. Let me just draw a line, actually. I mean the percent change, approximate percent change in this same time frame. So over here, if we see that it basically was down around -11% from the high, and in the same time, if we see from this particular level and mark this one, so it was up by almost more than 1.5% in Nifty. Now again, from this recent low that was around this March 2023, let me just quickly calculate the percentage change from here. So it's you can see it's 23.4% in Nifty. And in the same time, I'll try to calculate the percentage change in Dow Jones. So in Dow Jones, it's just 13.4%. And it has not yet breached the all-time high. And you see how Nifty is outperforming the world's largest economy. Correct. So let me just show you Nifty in a single chart. It will help you to understand the levels going forward. So previously in my last video, I told that on the upside, 750-800 was the level that I was watching, and above that I'll revise my levels actually. So you can see that Indian market is very indifferent compared to the global cues, correct? Irrespective of the global market, it is continuously going upside and maintaining its secular bull run. Even today, if we see the figures of FII, DII, we will find that FII has bought a huge number in cash market, that's around 5,223 crore, and DII of sold a bid that is around 1400. So FIIs are completely in a buy mode current in the, I mean, under the current scenario. So from here on, I am expecting that as it is hovering around 2855, I am expecting it to go a bit higher from here, and on the upside my level would be around 21100. That should be the level one should keep a minute watch, 21,100, if it goes on the higher side. And obviously, if it doesn't, we should obviously mark those levels as well. So the levels on the downside, we will mark as there is a gap. So you know that there is a gap in between these two candles. Why? Because Modi government won in the state election. Correct. So there is a huge gap over here. So if it comes down, the immediate support would be around this 20,500. That means the resistance of this particular gap. Let me just draw a quick line over here so that it becomes visually more clear to you. So this is the gap, correct? So this is the gap. So this is the ceiling of this gap. So if it comes downside, then 20,500 should be the level that needs to be watched. And below that, obviously, the floor of this particular gap, that is around 20,300. On the upside, the levels are 21,100, and on the downside, it's around 20,500, below which 20,300. Now we will quickly shift to Bank Nifty. Weekly chart. In this chart from Jan 2008, I have drawn one upward sloping trend line, which has connected all the highs. You can see it has connected all the highs, major highs. Now under these circumstances, under the present scenario, you see that Bank Nifty is making gaps and moving higher. So still there is a lot of room on the upside. On the upside, the levels can be close to 48,800 to 49,000. Clear? So once it goes towards that 48,800, 49,000, that's a very good level to go short in Bank Nifty. And on the downside, again, there is a gap. So from this gap, we know that the low of this particular candle, that is 45,470, and the high of this particular candle, that is around 44,950, or to be in round figures, that is 45,000, should be the level to watch. Till then, we can just mark these levels. 48,800 on the upside, and on the downside, it's around 45,000. So these two levels needs to be watched closely. If it gets breached on the downside, I'll further revise my levels and update you all. So I hope this video will add value to you. And if you want to share your thoughts, please do it in the comment section below. And obviously you can mail as well. Thanks for watching.